Very good afternoon, everyone gathered here through this Zoom platform. On behalf of the Department of Computer Science, Self-Financing Section 52, we welcome you all to this wonderful celebration on International Day of Democracy. And today, we are gathered on a very special day, that is International Day of Democracy, where we have to speak a lot about democracy, because this is a need of the hour, and the entire world is running towards this entire concept called democracy. So the democracy means the people will be ruling. Okay, the actual Greek term says people rule. So all those points will be discussed by our beloved students and also our resource person, wonderful resource person, beloved Ramashankar Singh. He's also joined with us. He will be also giving a lot of inputs on this democracy. So we will be all listening to all these things. So before getting into the function, we have to give a space for our Lord Almighty. So without his presence, we cannot do anything. So we will spend a few minutes in the presence of God. A song will be played, prayer song. We will pray. Then we will commence our actual program, the prayer song.
Showers of blessings, this is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessings, showers of blessings.
So now, so formal welcome the gathering. Let me request Dr. Gayatri, Associate Professor of Department of Computer Science, to welcome the gathering and also to introduce our beloved Chief Guest. Ma'am, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable Chief Guest, respected Mr. Pair, respected Principal, our beloved Head of the Department, learned professors, and all my dear students. I take this opportunity in welcoming all for the commemoration of International Day of Democracy to take part in the panel discussion and also with the talk of our expert. I'm very glad to welcome you all for this wonderful day here. Very glad to welcome our chief guest, honorable chief guest, Mr. Ramashankar Singh sir, advocate, High Court Lucknow, subject matter expert, ICAI CMA Lucknow, ex-finance officer, Baba Saheb Bhimrao Ambedkar Central University Lucknow, former deputy chief accounts officer, Kandla Port Trust, Gujarat, and he has expertise in many fields and some are listed here. He has is MCom from Ranchi University, LLB from Lucknow University, and he has gone through a CA Inter and ICW final, accounting technician certificate, company secretary certificate, BG diploma in cyber law from Lucknow, PG diploma in cyber security from Lucknow University, PG diploma in media law from Lucknow University, certification in forensic science and criminal investigation from Delhi University and Institute of Forensic Science, Delhi, PG diploma in educational administration. So heavy applause for our chief guest is much needed, I hope. Now we request our honorable chief guest to join and share his idea in the panel discussion and also to address the gathering and cast the light of his knowledge upon us. His comments are very essential for the students who want them to be like him one day. We would be delighted with your expertise in every way possible, sir. So without having any time for consuming, I would like to call upon Mr. Ramashankar Singh, sir, to accompany us to enlighten with his words of true wisdom. I welcome you, sir.
A very good afternoon to everyone present here. It is my pleasure to be a part of this panel discussion on the International Day of Democracy, organized by PG Department of Computer Science, Bishop Heber College, Tiruchirappalli. Firstly, I would like to thank Dr. Gayatri Madam for giving me this wonderful opportunity. I would also like to extend my gratitude to respected Dr. D. Chandrasekharan, Sir, Bishop of CSI, Tiruchirappalli, Thanjavur Diocese, Chairman and Secretary, College Governing Board. Respected Dr. Paul Dayabaran, Sir, Principal, and Dr. Sobar Ismail, David G., Associate Professor, Head of the Department, and all the participants present here. It is an honor to share this platform with you all today. Thank you for having me here.
Thank you, sir. Right now, our students are here and they will be having a panel discussion on the role of youth in strengthening Indian democracy. So nowadays, the youth are very enthusiastic and their role, we cannot simply avoid. But they are playing a major role in the building the democratic country. So we have to hear their opinion and hear a panel of students. Divya Bharati, Antia Miriam, Nitish Kumar, Valentina Sharing, Sudarshan, and Sharon Rose. So all these six students are ready with their opinion regarding the Indian democracy. And now I just hand over the session to the students and they will be having the discussion. After the discussion, our beloved chief guest, Ramashankar Singh sir, will deliver his address.
Now, student may proceed further so that we can.
Welcome.
Nitish Mark.
Yes, sir, you can start now.
Good afternoon to all. I thank everyone for giving me this opportunity. I submit my gratitude, greetings to the dignitaries of the board, the participants, and the audience of today's event. India. India is a five-letter word, which is itself strong. The whole world is astonished seeing India's growth. India is an embodiment of energy. My friends, the answer lies among us. Yes, you and me are the best source of energy that makes the Indian democracy and Indian constitution stronger. The youth are now into all possible spheres, enlivening the growth of India. Today's youth are productive, dynamic, enthusiastic, and even many more. These young brains have the power to make, break, and even have the potential to make change and lead a country. I personally believe that meaningful democracy requires meaningful participation of youth. The youth of India, as of any other country, has a major role in strengthening democracy and shaping our country. But how can this be done?
Good afternoon, everyone. Democracy in India, as elsewhere, is just not about periodic elections, nor about voter turnouts, or about voluntary. The central objective is to enable every citizen to have their right to say and to have the say in deciding about the great collective social worth.
That's completely right. In addition to that, democracy is a system in which the normative practices are accepted by the people, or we may say ruled by the people. Democracy is mandatory to all countries. Why? Do you have any ideas? Okay, let me tell you about it. Democracy is mandatory to all countries because it's every citizen should be wanted to assert it freely. Right? How the democracy is given to the world? It comes from two Greek words. Demos means a people and kratos means rule. In general, almost 34% of the population consists of youth. They have the power to change the nation. The young mind will be more proud and innovative. If the ruling power is given in the hand of the youth, I'm sure of that definitely India will become a developed nation in 2022.
Yes, I agree, Divya. Abraham Lincoln, the famous president of America, said, democracy is a government of people, by the people, for the people. Such as an important of democracy is liberty in a soul of democracy. India is in the biggest country in democracy world.
Mr. Sudarshan, I do feel that thing. There are certain essential conditions for the success of democracy. All people must be able to experience their participatory role in decision making. The human rights and fundamental rights, such as equality, liberty of thoughts, expression, belief, movement, communication, and association, must be protected by the Constitution.
I second you, Sharon. Now we are left only with the human resources, which can be divided into active human resource, which is none other than us, the youth, and the passive human resource, the people who are aged more than 40. In order to bring back the strength of our country, we need active participation of our youth, who occupies 27% of our nation's population, which is again the largest youth population in the world. Before that, the youth should know the power of democracy in the sense they should know that it is a tool for their freedom and right. In my opinion, to strengthen Indian democracy, an individual should know his role as a responsible citizen towards the democracy. Every youth should give his complete potential in their day-to-day lives regularly and responsibly to develop a society. But most of us forget our role and fall into a fake world of video games, drugs, and many, which stops us from living a useful life. When we youth give something to our democracy will, or it should, give something back to us for a wholesome development.
Exactly. We are into a dynamic family where the youths are not subjected into decision and part of decision making. Confidence, equality, and decision making arises only from our family.
Hence, there should be no discrimination and suppression among families. I do feel the same, Bharatina. Now, we are in a selfish state, but we having more responsibilities towards the country and the society too. So, we have to be grateful for our country. So, we should not be selfish for this country and society, and that's the duty, right?
Yes, I agree with you, Divya. When the youth or a career are very much interested in other countries, they are focused in their financial status and lifestyle families, but they are not ready to serve their mother's land. This look must be changed.
Yes, Sudarshan, I accept your point. Indian graduates do hold a major chunk of working population in major foreign countries, but unfortunately, we are in a situation where we cannot blame them, because they run for their survival and they work off to pay off their loans, their home debts and whatnot. We cannot accuse them of not working in our homeland. They may have or may not be have, they may have, they may be patriot or not, but that is not the question here. Situations like family debts, educational loans and society questions in the society peers make them to go abroad.
You're right, Nitish. Government policies which seem socialized, but actually it is capitalized, that is, laws in favor of corporate. So we, the youth, should be intuitive and check all the laws when once a government is formed. And we should fight for our rights if the laws are against us. Added to this, the policies might be good for the national development, but it is our role to see keenly whether it is good for the development of our democracy. Before 10 to 15 years, people were not educated about democracy. They didn't have any platform to be aware of. But now, though we lack educationally, we have platform to know about our rights and what powers do we have in this democratic country. Even now, we can't find the emotion to serve towards it. So whose fault it is? Passive humans, apart from youth, passive humans should know their role to stimulate and encourage youngsters to know about their responsibility towards their serving in democracy, in a democratic country. Other thing, the youth should also know that they have much to donate to the democracy from their creativity to innovation.
Yes, I agree with that point. Inclusion of political science in curriculum, which would help the students to gain more knowledge in the field of politics. Only then the impact of voting and participate can pave way to better Indian constitution. Yes, Sharon, I endorse your statement. We do not trust the social media as we see. We have to analyze which one is right and which one is wrong. And as a youth, we very well know about as far as bad things are right and wrong, everything which surrounds us. So please don't share any wrong information that you haven't seen in the social media.
I totally support Sharon's point. Including political science in our curriculum could do wonders in this democratic nation. India, the year 2018 was an important year in the Indian calendar because it was the year when 21st generation youths attained 18 years and they finally will be adults and they can be a part of a democracy. And including political science in our curriculum could do wonders because they will know about our democracy. They can make their own decisions and they will know what to question and what not and who to support and who not. So it should be great for our country in the future.
Yes. According to the report of MOSPI 2021, the percentage of youth in India is 34.33%. But the whole votes by the youth is 12.4, which is almost 22% who are not making their votes. To make democracy work, we must be a nation of participants. Therefore, there is a challenge in front of everyone to find the correct solution for the problem. It is only by exercising the right to vote. This is not a single step process. It contains a lot of campaigns and awareness programs. 100% voting will surely make a change, which is a must need in current era. As Valentina, in addition to that, I would like to share with you about the literacy. Literacy is a very important quality of the population. So now the obstacles for a serious obstacle to our economic development in a democracy is the illiteracy. That means a low level of literacy, we can say that. But according to the, would like to share a fact about it. According to that, in 2001, the census of a person who attained the age of 7 and above can able to read and write with the understanding of that any language term as the literacy. But now, in 2021, 3rd May at Chennai, a genius girl named Sarah, she is a 2 years and 9 months old baby. She recited 116 periodic tables in a dashboard and placed a world record.
I agree with you, Divya. I would also like to add this point. Both by a widespread electoral practice in many low and middle income families. Even though it's against the law, people never hesitate to receive these monies. Knowing the fact that these monies are spent from the taxes which we pay to the government for our well-being. This is due to poverty and many other reasons. This should be stopped for a better democracy. Coming to the impact of social media in politics. It is a platform encompass websites such as Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter, etc. In particular, it is now a serious factor in political campaign and in the way the people thinks about any issue. And this is the platform where rumors, fake information, and confusion among people happens. It also has a positive impact, like creating opportunities for the voters to interact with the candidates. So now it is again in our hands to check whether the information are true or false and act accordingly.
I agree with that point. The internet has created a channel of communication that plays a key role in circulating news. Through the use of social media in election process context, diplomacy in the world has become less private and sensitive to the public perception. Economic development in the field manufacturers. In field manufacturing and industrial requirement employees, there are many youths getting employed, which improves the opportunity of youth. I'm also very much happy in sharing this news. According to the Global Manufacturing Risk Index 2021, India has bagged the second place, which is actually a great thing, which by surpassing USA, even in this COVID situation.
As Dr. Valentina and Divya had earlier talked about literacy and industries in our country, but the impact they have in our country would not have been possible if not for liberalization in our country. Before 1991, Indian business success was a function of ambition, licenses, and government contacts. The decisions were based on contacts through contacts and not of the market competition or situation. Business goals reflected directly to the continuation of the Swadeshi movement. During that era, before 1991, entrepreneurship was subdued, capital was limited, and this in turn made the society risk-averse, and every individual citizen was looking for employment stability. And then came the 1991 liberalization. This made India open to the world. And this also had an important effect on democracy, youth empowerment, and also on economy. Although liberalization has happened in 1991, it still has the effect still on the present day. Then it had the effect on MNC companies, and now it has come to startups. After liberalization, there were great impacts like reduction in heterogeneity, poverty, illiteracy, and increase in GDP of the country and employment. Startups also play a major role in democracy as well as the economy. Earlier Antia mentioned that youths are not as responsible, but there are some, like example, Deepinder Goyal of Zomato, who had nothing at the beginning, and 2015 he had a startup named Zomato, and today it has IPO listing in our stock markets. it is not a easier thing for an individual. And same is the Ola company started by Honey Technologies. And today they have a factory where 10,000 women employees work in our nation. It's in Krishnagiri, Tamil Nadu. So you definitely have an important part of a democracy, and they are also responsible, and they will make great impacts.
Yes, Nitish, you're right. We can also develop Indian economy through sports. Sports is an instrument to improve the mental health and the physical health of a nation's human resource. It also promotes unity and nation's pride, which helps us to work better to make a better democracy. Our sports people achieve celebrity status and promote positive images, which invites many sponsorship, which eventually, obviously, which increases our economy of India. Many foreign sports industries have also shown interest in entering the Indian market. Other than this, sports offer a number of employment, which also supports the Indian economy. And it also proves that involvement in sports leads a high-style life. Genuine commercial opportunities are also emerging in India for sports service providers. There is an increase in appetite of India's education sector of sports training, which is of a great support for our Indian Sports Development Authority. For example, if we take as a present example, we can say IPL is a $1 billion business in India.
In addition, when it comes to campaign and other programs, it's very important to come forward. Either active or passive, come forward. Social activities like campaign and other programs can find the correct solution for the problem.
Yes, I accept it, Sarah. IT sector. When it comes to IT field, both sectors and the BPO play a central role, where the youth get see a lots of opportunities for their highly successful.
Youth being the spur of India, being united, we lead our country to the utmost success. When we, the youth, start being a question and to raise the question against justice, then there lies real democracy. If we are looking for a revolution in politics, we definitely need a back. Those stirring youths of our Indian freedom. Only then the deadly hand of corruption can be rooted out by the immortal power of youth. Our suggestion is that inclusion of political science in our curriculum will help the students to gain more knowledge in the field of politics, which would create an impact of voting and participation to make Indian constitution better. Only then democracy can fulfill its true aim, that is equality, justice and freedom to God. Thank you.
Thank you, dear students, for your wonderful participation in the panel discussion. Now let me invite our beloved chief guest, our Ramashankar Singh sir, to give your inputs and address the gathering. Sir, please, sir, this is your time, sir.
This is a very good participation of the students. So far, International Day of Democracy, we know, all know, ki it is a celebration on the basis of which we have come to a overall conclusion about this democracy is what. And I can say that democracy is a good thing because it is for the people, by the people to run. That is basically it is a rule of majority of the people, for the people and by the people. And certainly it's a very good as a common person as well as for running a government in a particular state or country with certain conditions, we can say, because our geographical area or our physical or population area, it impact one and all, and we have to take in a totality looking to various parameters and factors. As a whole, it's a really good that we should go only for the democracy, for running a government in general, and even all other institutions also, democracy is taken as a base because majority rule apply, and we, if we want to run the organization or a country or a state, we have to go on the basis of the majority rule. Now I will share a screen on the this auspicious occasion of International Day of the Democracy, where I have certain aspect to say. So basically, the International Day of Democracy, conducted by PG Department of Computer Science, Bishop Heber College, Tirupati, is a very good attempt to train the student so that they can come with a very great, great way for their career progression. So actually, this is a really very wonderful thing has been done by the college. On that occasion, I will share my certain PPT related to our International Day of Democracy, how it took place and what is the significance and basic history of that. The significance of the International Democracy is very important for all of us, and we are celebrating this today on the 17th September 2021. The basic main significance of the International Democracy is that it urges all the people, government, to respect human rights and provide meaningful participation in the democracy. What our students just participate in the discussion is really a wonderful thing. And the another issue is that it is celebrated to educate the public on the issue of concern, basically for mobilize political will. This is a very important aspect of this, mobilize the political will and resources to address problem worldwide and reinforce the achievement of the humanity. That is the crux of the issue. The people and organization celebrate this very day differently in their states, countries, but the main motto to raise awareness and events like debates was rightly conducted by the college, Heber College, in this today's day, because it is a International Day of Democracy. I congratulate the management and the student who participated in a very well presented manner. The various public campaign are also organized to acknowledge the day, to hail the democracy throughout the country as well as internationally. That is the basic significance of the today's day, that International Day of the Democracy. The importance of International Day of Democracy is that it started on 8th November 2007 by the UNGA, United Nations General Assembly, resolved to observe this International Day of Democracy on 15th of September every year. And accordingly, it started in the year 2008 onward. And the basic purpose of this to disseminate knowledge and educate the people. Accordingly, it is a universal value-based system to express freely on the democracy and other aspect of the government. In the United Nations version, the International Day of Democracy provides an opportunity to review the state of democracy in the world. Democracy is as much as a process as a goal, and only with the full participation of the international community can the ideal of the democracy to be made into a reality. What we all are making efforts, and this panel discussion is also part of that, so that our student and younger generation may be educated well, they can understand the impact of the democracy, and country may go better because of the implementation of the basic philosophy of the democracy. The basic background about this is that in September 1997, India Inter-Parliamentary Union, IPU, adopted a universal declaration of democracy through some forum of special activities to be held on 15 September, what I have already mentioned. On 15 September 2008, the International Day of Democracy was celebrated at the House of Parliaments in Geneva. First time it was celebrated in Geneva, and national parliaments were invited to organize their own democracy related activities. इसमें नेशनल पार्लियामेंट को इनवाइट किया था, काफी लोगों ने पार्टिसिपेट किया है. द इम्फेसिस द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी व्हाट इट इन्वॉल्व्स द चैलेंजेस इट फेसेस एज वेल एज द अपॉर्चुनिटी इट ऑफर्स एंड द सेंट्रल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी दैट ऑल पार्लियामेंट हैव टू बी ए की इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर द डेमोक्रेसी मीनिंग देयर बाई द मेजॉरिटी स्टेट्स गवर्नमेंट हैव टू फॉलो द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द डेमोक्रेसी फॉर स्मूथ running of the government and give the freedom of many aspects, including what our Indian constitution take freedom of expression and so many things. They examine and also to examine and discuss how well parliament perform in democratic function possibility on the basis of self-assessment and identify what steps it may take to strengthen its effect and significance of that. In the same way, it was continued, and especially on 2013 onward, it taken a very good momentum, and International Day of Democracy in 2013 was celebrated, and with a, you can say that view that it should promote democracy and Raj. There is some technically about this battery discharge. Just wait. The basic theme of this. There is some technical glitches that I may review. The basic theme of this International Day of Democracy in 2013 was strengthening a voice of the democracy was put forth, and online contests were launched. At that time, 162 countries around the world had participated in this celebration. In the same way, in the year 2014, the theme was engaging youth on democracy, what our student is also referring to that, and urge action and change the mindset of the people. That was taken as a base and basic purpose to engage for the change was adopted, and a base was taken for that purpose. In the year 2015, the theme was space for civil society. That is, you know, all we are residing in the society, it may be village, it may be city, it may be town, that is very important aspect for livelihood. For that, space for civil society was the theme in the year 2015. And similarly, in the year 2016, the democracy and the 2030 agenda for the sustainable development was taken in the International Day of Democracy of 2016, which covers a wide coverage, I can say, wide scope, how we should promote ourselves, how to behave, and how to go ahead has been demarcated in the year 2016 while making the theme. In the same way, in the year 2018, in the year 2000, democracy under the strain, because we face a lot of problem from the other forces, you can say opposition about that. Then a theme was kept, democracy under the strain, solution for a changing the world. A lot of problem has been faced during that period to how to resolve it, this theme was kept. And this was coinciding with the 70th anniversary of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, because human right is one of the important aspects in the present era and also for society and as a country, state as a large, for which this value has been taken, where values of freedom and in respect of human rights is an essential element of the democracy has been invested in the year 2018, which is a right step in that direction. The theme for 2019 was participation, which is one of the important aspects, because for opportunity to recall the democracy, participation from all level is must. Maximum participation will give a better result, and accordingly it was taken. And really it's a wonderful that we try to progress in a very free, you can say, without fear and favor like a thing. In the same way, the theme for 2020, we all know that we are suffering a lot due to COVID-19, and our almost all the activities has been paralyzed because of COVID-19. And I take it one way, it's a good also, because this blessing in disguise that we come heavily on this online platform, we never earlier thought of. Even lot of efforts have been made by government for this purpose of the go for this smart classes, and but it has not given a very good result, though the present government through Digital India tried to do a lot. To some extent they have succeeded also, but because of the COVID-19, we know we forced to change, and even everybody changed. Nowadays you can see how we are meeting. It's a really wonderful, and certainly a benefit is going to be extended a lot to our student because of this online platform. And now it is made available one to all at a very less cost, I can say. Even lot of things is available across world free of cost or a very less cost. So really it's a, I can say it is a good for mankind, we can say, though COVID-19 is not good, but after effect that adoption of this online platform really a wonderful, and I hope this whole world will take benefit, especially wonderful for the children, though it's a problem also for the children who are the younger and not able to understand, because we have to take this online platform with certain caution, because a lot of good thing as well as bad thing is available, which is to be monitored, controlled by our parents, especially for the younger children. And this way, the International Day of Democracy 2021, a theme for this is for International Day of Democracy to be celebrated today, what, 15th September 2021, today, has been set a opportunity to recall the democracy about the people, because of this certain latest government, that is also a very right theme to recall the democracy, which because certain changes is required in that way. Sometimes you feel also, because I don't want to mention particular, when there is absolute majority also, in that there is a problem in such case. Opposition should be strong so that what shortcoming, what lapses is done by the government should be taken care in a proper sense and manner. So that way democracy is built on inclusion, equal treatment, and participation, and it's a fundamental building block for the peace, sustainable development, human rights in nutshell. So that was the thing. And so far democracy, how it started, I will like to brief about that. Basically, the birth of democracy is Athens, which started first democracy in ancient Greece around 500 BC. The literature about Athenian democracy spans over the century, with the earliest works being a Republic of Plato and Politics of Aristotle, continuing with Disclosure of the Niccolo Machiavelli. Similarly, Athenian democracy was invented by Cleisthenes, known as father of the democracy, was an ancient Greece's most enduring contribution to the modern world. The Greek system of direct democracy would pave the way of representative democracies across the globe. However, the form of democracy was varying from time to time and state to state, and also from country to country. Basically, this democracy is an open system, representative system, tolerance system, accommodative system, government by dissension, argumentative system. What we just see our student and participated, that is a part of the argument. Argumentative system, we go for the argumentation of the system, responsive system and responsible system as well. And thereafter, it's a question, why democracy? We earlier discussed the rule by majority, of the people, for the people, by the people. And it is taken as a best way for the administration in a country as well as a state. The basic purpose of this modern human values is important for one and all, that is equality, liberty, fraternity, or brotherhood. These are the basic human values in the modern scenario, and it is required to be done. The democracy ensures all the above human values. That is why it is required to be done, because of its universal application. It's applicable to one and all, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, and all these things. And so far evaluation is concerned, basically taken place in 16th century. There is a resonance in Europe, and there is also impact of philosophy of Lord Buddha at that time. And thereafter, in 1776, American Revolution took place. Besides, in 1789, French Revolution has also taken place. And what we discuss about the direct democracy initially, that in the previous slide, that direct democracies, that time Yunnan, Greece, Athens, Delphi, Thebes, Corinth, these are the countries where direct democracy was introduced initially. However, there is also not satisfaction about the direct democracy, though Mexico was against it, it percentage 85%, even it was started the Greece, but percentage of not satisfaction with the direct democracy 84%, Brazil 83%, Spain, Tunisia, Italy, South Africa, Argentina, Nigeria, US, Japan, UK, Hungary, France, Russia, Kenya, Poland, they are not satisfied with this direct democracy, and there the way it is going at relevant time. In the same way, in India also there is democracy in different we can say way, but it is a democracy far maybe different, that is available at that time in Vaishali, Magad, Takshila, Kapilvastu, Lichvi, Kusinara, Pava project province, and it is a, in addition to that, there is democracy in southern part of the India, various state and princely state is there, where democracy is there far may be different, because there is a council of minister concept is also there, when a king or queen or nabab take decision on the basis of the decision taken by the council of minister, and like that this thing is there, like we know about the Akbar Birbal, lot of example is there, how Akbar take decision when there is a problem, he always calling their council minister Birbal and taking advices. The same way, at that time, India has a more than 560 princely states prior to you can say independence. At that time, there is a move. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel and Mr. V.P. Menon made a lot of effort for the organization of state, because that time a colonial system is there, British rule is there, where the slavery system was there. Looking to all this arrangement made by that time, the people of India about the freedom movement, struggle and all these things. Anyway, that took place and we made independent thereafter in 1947, and we have our constitution in 1950. And in the thereafter, this a Fazal committee recommended reorganization of certain princely state, which could not taken place at that time. But in year 1966, the reorganization was agreed, and that has the effect that princely state has status has gone, and privy purse system has also been introduced, which latter part it was abolished through privy purse abolition amendment act of 26 in the year 1971. This way we came to complete, we can say, democracy in India also, because at that time, prior to that, there are five princely states: Junagadh, Hyderabad, Kashmir, Mysore, Indore. Later, only three: Junagadh, Hyderabad, and Kashmir. Even the some part of the Kutch also, that this we can say princely state. Later part, that Kutch state was given certain portion. I'm fortunate enough to serve Kandla Portras as the deputy chief accounts officer. That is a part of the princely state of the Kutch, which was handed over to Kandla Portras. And the after partition, that responsibility of relocation, rehabilitation of the Pakistan, who coming from the Pakistan, that you can Sindhi, they have been settled, matlab, they have been resettled in Kutch, known as. All these are the very good steps by the government through this democratic system, our government, because India has a union system of the government, and presently we have 28 states and 9 united territory after this abolition of 370 article that we all know. In this way, India, there is a universal application of that we discuss. India, there is a universal application adult franchise because of the limited democracy. Later in 1948, Universal Declaration of Human Rights adopted by the India also. That was the, I can say, very good efforts, and you can say that is attempt was made in that way. Basically, I want to say that although there is more than 25 are in the row of the to be regarded father of democracy in India, so far India is concerned, lot of issues were there, especially the role of Mahatma Gandhi and Subhash Chandra Bose. We can't say their role is there, but it was taken as a father of the nation. Same way, father of Republic India, the role of B.R. Ambedkar, our Padma Shri, and this Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Bharat Ratna awardee, he has also contributed a lot for the framing of Constitution of India. And the role of father modern India, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, cannot be ignored, because this burning alive empire concept was there in the princely state, because it is a, you can say, customary or a system. When a husband is died, then wife of the deceased is also go for that burning alive empire, which was totally against the, you can say, humanity, and it is opposed a lot by Raja Ram Mohan Roy, which was taken place in the British colonial system in the year 1829 by the Lord William Bentinck with the help of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Hence, his contribution cannot be forgotten in such a situation. In the same way, there is a Potti Sri Ramalu, father of linguistic democracy, because India has a diversified state and there is so many language. In that case, it cannot be ignored, because we made India as a union, as a part. In such case, it's so obvious, different language create a lot of problem at that time, that English was taken and then later Hindi as a taken as a Rajbhasa for the India as a whole. And always, you know, 14 December, September, Rajbhasha Divas is celebrated so that integration part should be well represented and accepted by the people in due course of time. But basically, this is the, as a whole, old, I can say about the ancient India, after the constitution of India, why we gone for that, what we discussed earlier about the three aspects we have taken for the democracy, and that is very well done in our constitution of India. But modern human value, we discuss equality, liberty, and fraternity. These three modern human values have been taken due place in our constitution of India, and preliminary declares India to be a sovereign, socialistic, secular, and democratic republic, and objective is stated in the preamble are secure justice, liberty, equality, fraternity, and justice include social, economical, and political. And same way, liberty means expression of thought, belief, faith, and worship, because India is a secular state, and we know in India, all religion, caste are given equal importance. Looking to that aspect, this expression of belief, faith, and worship has been enshrined in our constitution. In the same way, equality of status and opportunity, and to promote among all, that opportunity should be provided to all, irrespective of their labels, caste, creed, religion, that is enshrined in our constitution of India. Same way, fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and unity of the nation. It is one of the prerequisites for unity of a nation. Dignity of the individual has to maintain in all spheres of their life. This was our constitution of India, and democracy of India basically union model, where center has power to issue direction to the respective state, and even they can change many things, including state demarcation and all these things, which is not available with the United States. That is, I will come later. The basic democracy of India is that India is a parliamentary democratic republic in which the president of India is a head of state, and the prime minister of India is a head of the government. That we go for that way. That executive functioning, we know, judiciary functioning is there, which is independent from the institution, and that based on the federal, it is a based on the federal government, although the word is not used, this word is not used in the constitution of India itself. The American scholar Casey Weed in 1973 has opined that India is a quasi federalism, because we not go exactly and what United Nations is following. That is about the India. I would like to discuss some of the important country and how they go adopted the democracy. So far, United Nations is concerned, it is a democracy. A core value of the United Nations is that the Union supports democracy by promoting human rights, development, and peace and security. Human rights aspect is taken care of. What is the modern human value is taken care in the United Nations. In the 75th year, since UN Charter was signed, the UN has done more to support democracy around the world than any other global organization. And Republican democracy has been followed there, where the head of state, a federal system is there, head of government is a democratic system. And because this UN, there is several states, they have their own constitution, and they have following that. In such a case, in federal, this federal, the head of the state has no power to issue direction like Union of India, like our union government, a lot of direction to the state also, except though it is covered in the concurrent list, like you see the education, it is a state list as well as a central list. Then the decision or direction issued by the government of India is binding to the state also. In the same security aspect, that state subject is there, however, central also. So such situation, union government can give a direction to the state. However, this is not available in the United States because of the federal system of this, their head of state and head of the government. Similarly, in UK, it is a different system. The United Kingdom unitary state with the devolution that is governed. I think there is some technical glitches in the PPT. Anyway, I will discuss, no issue for that. The United Kingdom is a unitary state with devolution. Devolution that is governed with the framework of the parliamentary democracy under the constitution. The monarchy system is there, in which the monarch is king or queen. Currently, Queen Elizabeth II is the head of state, while the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, currently Boris John, is the head of the government. That system in the you can say United Kingdom, the same way democracy in the Britain, democracy, parliamentary government in Britain was not yet a democratic system, we can say. However, mainly because of the property requirement, the franchise was held by only about 5% of the British population over 20 years of age. The Reform Act of 1832, which is generally viewed as a historic threshold in the development of the parliamentary democracy in Britain, extended the suffrage to about 7% of the adult population. It would require further acts of parliament in 1867, 1884, and 1918 to achieve universal male suffrage, and one more law enacted in 1928 to secure the right to vote for all the adult women was, you can say, enforced in democracy and in Britain. As a whole, this is a whole about the democracy. And with this, I conclude my presentation, and now we may go for question answer on any issue to that. Now floor is open for question and answer, if anybody has, so that we can have a discussion about that.
Yes, dear students, if you have any queries, our chief guest is ready to answer your queries. And you can post your questions in the chat box. So totally nearly 200 students are here. So if you switch on the mic, it will be not good. So better just send your queries through the chat box.
I think there is no query from the student side or the participant side. So now management may proceed further.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your participation. As a formal closure, I will invite Professor Maheshwari ma'am to propose the vote of thanks. Ma'am, please.
I would maintain that thanks are the highest form of thought, and that gratitude is happiness doubled by wonder. The essence of all beautiful art is gratitude. I deem it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of PG Department of Computer Science, Jaipur College, Shifted 2. First of all, I extend my most sincere thanks to Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. Next, I would like to express my deep sense of thankfulness to our principal. I would like to thank our beloved head of the department, Dr. G. Sobhasmiles David sir, for his moral support and guidance. On behalf of PG Department of Computer Science, I extend a hearty vote of thanks to our chief guest, Mr. Ram Shankar Singh Advocate, High Court Lucknow, who sparked time for his busy schedule to grace the occasion. Today we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts, and
and this will surely be going to encourage us to and the students. Your thoughts have enlightened our minds and have shown us a new path. Thank you, sir. My gratitude to all the students, panel speakers for raising their question and sharing their opinions today. And also I would like to thank Dr. Mrs. Jacinta Ma'am for coordinating the students for panel discussion. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to thank all the staff members and IT support who made this seminar a grand success. Finally, the wonderful students, thank you so much for your cooperation. Once again, I thank all for your cordial cooperation. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Dear students, the feedback link is already available in the chat box. Please don't forget to give your feedback. And once again, thank you all for joining. Especially, we would like to thank our chief guest also. Among his busiest schedule, he joined today and gave a lot of inputs on the democracy. Once again, thank you all. We will meet you all in another webinar. Thank you so much. Goodbye.